What's up, YouTube? This is your boy, it's Gyro, and we're back once again with another Battlefield 3 gameplay. Today we're going to be playing on Operation 925 Team Deathmatch. I think this is a 200% ticket, 200 ticket round, and I get like a quarter of the kills, so 51 kills and 11 deaths or something like that. Playing with the AUG A3 and then running with the 93R as my sidearm and the med kit. Playing that team aspect, keeping everybody alive that I can, like you should if you're playing TDM as a fucking assault. Revive people, but make sure that the area is clear before you just start Rambo reviving people, okay? Thank you. So enjoy the gameplay. We got 13 minutes, everybody. Just about that, we're going to be talking about lots of different stuff. Very first thing, though, is the Battlefield 3 new premium edition announcement trailer. Yesterday, I talked about the premium edition and why people were crying like little babies and shit, and how they just need to get over it because what you're doing is supporting your developers, and that's all you're doing. And if you don't like supporting your developers to have them make better games, then don't buy games. Don't play games. Don't do none of that, you know? So, if you all did not see the new Premium Edition announcement trailer, they showed off all of the maps like Back to Kharkan, Close Quarters DLC. Then they also showed the new Armored Kill and also a sneak peek at Aftermath. Now, if you guys notice in the Aftermath, few screens that they showed of it, you know, the little sneak peek teaser that they had, it was a... earthquake-ridden buildings that were just destroyed. I mean, it just looked like buildings were completely destroyed, and if I'm not mistaken, that is supposed to be another fast-paced, like, DLC, kind of how Close Quarters was supposed to be. So if you guys haven't seen the trailer, then check out the link below in the description, or I'll put a annotation in the video. Anyways, though, next game we're going to be talking about is Crysis 3, and they had a new gameplay trailer that reveals Hunter multiplayer mode. And what that is, pretty much, is the Crysis guys, they wear a suit that is called a nano suit, and it pretty much gives them, like, superhuman abilities along with predator cloaking abilities. They can jump super high, run super fast, be punching people up through walls, and shit like that. So the Hunter mode, though, it supports up to 16 players at a time. There are two teams, a large group of cell troopers and a very small group of cloaked hunters. And what they were saying is like two hunters up against 14 cell troopers, and there will be two people that are the hunters that will be wearing the nano suits, and then they will also have a few cool gadgets like a bow and a few other things. They will also be able to go camo and all that. Now the cell faction, which is the 14 other players that are not the hunters, will have to be getting from point A to point B from what I took in the trailer, and they will have to get to a extraction point. So it looks like a pretty cool mode, and of course everybody will want to be the hunter, but I wonder how the game will actually play out in the multiplayer aspect, because I got Crysis 2 whenever it first came out, and I played the beta for Crysis 2, and I really enjoyed the beta. The beta was really, really good, and so I thought the overall game was going to be really, really good. So I bought the game, pre-ordered the game, got it, all that fun stuff, and then played it, and the game was good until you get up to a certain rank. Now, it's the type of game that the higher the rank you are, the more powerful weapons you have, gadgets you have, your suit you can, like, upgrade by just playing the game and using all the different abilities and stuff. So, it's just a game wherever once you get to the highest rank, you're pretty much pwning anybody else who is a lower rank than you. And it's just really unfair aspect to a game, and I hope that they do fix that with Crysis 3, but I guess we shall see. But the new Hunter mode reveal trailer gameplay, that looks really awesome, and I think that will be a lot of fun. I still don't know if I'm going to be picking up Crysis 3 brand new. I will definitely rent it before I get it, you know, so I can see what's up with it. But comment below, tell me what you all think of the Crysis 3, if you've seen it, or if you're interested in it. And then finally, we're going to be talking about some Black Ops shit. Now, there's a link. The very first link that's going to be of the Black Ops is going to be a whole bunch of videos that you guys can go watch of the new maps. And they show previews and all. And this is all from Gamescom. That's happening right now. And then we're going to be talking about all of the new brand new weapons and perks and kill streaks and all different types of shit. So they're going to be bringing a lot of stuff to Black Ops 2, like assault rifles. Here's a few AN-94, SMR, MAA-1, Type 25, SA-58, SIG-556, and the SCAR-H. I'll just name them all, why not? So they have three shotguns that we have already seen in the videos that they've released, and the shotguns are the M1216, the Saiga 12, and the R870 MCS Combat. So 870 Combat shotgun. Now light machine guns, they have the LSAT, the QBB LSW, and the MK48. Sniper rifles, they have DSR 50, SVU AS, and Ballista. And then for special, they have that cool assault shield that you can put down and put your gun through and shoot through. Submachine guns are going to be the MP7, the Chicom QCB, the PDW57, the Scorpion Evo 3, and MSMC. Secondary weapons like launchers are going to be small RPG FJH18AA, which is the Stinger, I think. Not the Javelin, like I said in my last video, which was incorrect, you know. Pistols are going to be the KAP-40, the TAC-45, Executioner, U-23R. And then no weapon equipped, combat knife. Woo woo woo! Here's some primary attachments for the assault rifle only. Reflex scope, ACOG, target finder, which is a sight which highlights enemies when they enter the field of view. Hybrid optic suppressor. Fast mag, adjustable stock, quick draw, grenade scanner, millimeter scanner, grenade launcher, select fire, FMJ, and extended clip. Secondary attachments, which is pistol only, is going to be reflex, suppressor, extended clip, fast mag, FMJ, dual wield, and laser sight. Now, your different perks that you get to have for your character are going to be perk 1, flak jacket, take less explosive damage, duh, ghost, cannot be detected by enemy UAVs while moving, duh, blind eye, unaffected by AI controlled perks, I don't know what that is exactly, hardline, receive bonus score points, so of course you just get more points than you would before, lightweight, move faster, take no damage from falling. That's pretty nice. Perk 2, we got hardwired, immune to counter UAV and enemy EMPs. Scavenger, replenish ammo and grenades from fallen enemies. Cold-blooded, resistance to targeting systems including dual band, target finder, sensor grenades, and player-controlled aircraft. Toughness, flinch less when shot, so that will be maybe kind of cool for snipers with the toughness. Fast hands, swap grenades faster, use grenades and equipment faster, and safely throw back frag grenades. Then we have perk 3, engineer, show enemy equipment in the world, delay explosives, and re-roll and booby trap care packages. So I wonder if they'll hopefully fix that re-roll shit. Dead silence, move silently, extreme conditioning, sprint for a longer duration. Now, I don't know if that's infinite sprint, but it says for a longer duration. Tactical mask, reduce the effect of flash, concussion, and shock charges. And awareness, enemy movements are easier to hear, so that's just pretty much like in the Call of Duty 4. Dexterity, climb ladders and mantle over objects faster, recover from melee faster, and aim faster after sprinting. That will also probably be a good thing for these snipers in Call of Duty. Now, lethal grenades, they got grenade, produces lethal radius damage upon detonation. Semtex, grenade that sticks to surfaces before detonating. Combat axe, retrievable axe that causes instant death on impact. Claymore, directional anti-personal mine that triggers a proximity-based explosion C4 plastic explosive device that can be set and triggered remotely and bouncing better, which is from MW3 proximity mine that launches into the air before detonating, can be avoided by crouching or going prone. Oh yes. Tactical grenade, you got sensor grenade, flashbang, concussion, shock charge, which is a deployable charge which stuns enemies that enter its proximity, EMP grenade, tactical insertion, smoke grenade, black hat PDA, which is hack equipment and care packages or disable enemy vehicles, and one additional point can be spent on any tactical grenade to bring two of the same type into the battle when you spawn. Huh, wild cards, you have primary gunfighter, allows a third attachment for the primary weapon. Secondary gunfighter allows a second attachment for the secondary weapon. Overkill, take a primary weapon as your secondary, so they're bringing that back from Call of Duty 4 again. Yes, perk 1 greed, take a second perk 1. Perk 2 greed, take a second perk 2. Perk 3 greed, take a second perk 3. And tactician, take a tactical grenade in place of your lethal grenade. You got score streaks, which there's just so many to list, so I'm not even going to go through them. As the gameplay and commentary is coming to an end here, I'll just name a few actually. So you got RCC, 325 points, which is the very first one, a remote controlled car packed with explosives. Here comes a little RC buggy back to Black Ops once again. UAV, show enemies on the minimap. And the very top, point one, which is called Swarm, 1400 points, call in a swarm of lethal hunter killer drones that search and destroy enemies. So they're gonna be like little nanobite bug things that are probably killing everybody, which I don't know. You also get canine units right before that at 1275 points, attack dogs that hunt down the enemies. So they're bringing that back from World at War and all that fun stuff once again. But tell me what you guys think of the Black Ops stuff. I mean, they're definitely trying to change stuff around, I think, with this game. Now, tell me if you guys think it's going to be for the better or for the worse. And also tell me what you guys' opinions on the Crysis 3 trailer and also the Battlefield 3 Premium trailer. Anyways, I think I'm out of here as this commentary's already been too fucking long and I'm just totally out of it by now. So if you all enjoyed, then be sure to slap that like button and comment below. Share your opinions with me. Yes, later.